Welcome back to Profit From It. Today, friends, we are going to discuss on Nifty what we have discussed during last month, that is starting of the July. What actually happened during last month? What to expect this month, that is awesome August? Now, your expectation may be different and actually it may be different. So we need to plan A and plan B. So what to do in the month of August or in coming time? So let us plan A as well as plan B. Plan A is if it happens as you are expecting, and plan B, what happened if the things come in your way which you have not expected, right? We need to plan in advance is board of things. Nifty current year growth, right? So as you all are aware about it, that right now overall world is in degrowth, right? So actually, what is the current quarter one growth of Nifty companies, right? We need to see actual figure. Nifty 80% weightage, which companies are having 80% weightage in Nifty 50, which sector is having 80% weightage in Nifty 50, what is the revenue and profit of this 80% weightage companies? We will discuss Nifty 80% weightage earning estimate of this year, that is 19-20. We'll find intrinsic value of Nifty and just learn how yield works, right? And at the last, I will give you some exercise. Okay, so ready? Let us move as per plan. So first we have to discuss about Nifty, that what we discussed last month, what happened and what to expect in the coming month, right? As you know, we discuss these things. So let me go to our Profit From It site. Where's the profit? So profit site here. See, as you would be a daily update Nifty list. Yes, we update daily Nifty level, weekly Nifty level, monthly as well as yearly, right? So here is the Nifty view of daily, weekly, monthly and yearly. Right now we are talking on monthly, that is what we discussed in the July and what we are expecting in the month of August. So see, here is the view for amazing August, right? So it was not awesome August, it was amazing August. What we discussed in July, Nifty was 11,789 during jolly July. Let me see, really it was or not. Yeah, see here you can see, let me convert it to month. Yeah, here it was July, right? Correct, this was the month of July. So Nifty was at 11,789. We discussed that most important level to track this whole month should be 11,625. So why we have discussed to track 11,625? Because see, since last several months, we have not seen lower low. Yes, we were seeing higher high and hence we were seeing higher low. Higher close, maybe, may not. But yes, low we were seeing higher every month. So this month low was supposed to be tracked. So 11,625, as you can see here, see it was previous month low. So till the time Nifty doesn't break its habit was not breaking low. So till Nifty does not break the previous month low, we should be positive. If Nifty break its previous month low, then we should expect that Nifty could make a U-turn and for some month it can show lower low, lower high, lower close. So we were not supposed to track high this month because making high was a normal thing. We were supposed to track low. All right. So 11,625 was low. Negative trend for next 2 months could again re-enter, continuing the correction mode started since last 17 month. only in case if Nifty falls below 11,625. So what we have discussed, that if Nifty falls below 11,625, we may see negative trend. Nifty entered into negative trend. Falling below 11,625 can stretch the fall further toward 11,575, 11,361, or even 11,097. So watch 11,625 as the decisive level this whole month. So we were going to talk 11,625. Now, if 11,625 was supposed to break, then first we will see 11,575. So let me draw a line at 11,575. Yeah, it's here. It would fall further to 11,361. So where's 11,361? Yeah, it's here. And third target was 11,097, right? So 11,097, yeah, here. So what we were expecting, that Nifty would fall in this way, and major target was 11,097, right? So how much fall it was? Almost about 700 point. Watch 11,625 decisive level. Positive trend could continue further again with new lifetime high toward 12,317 or 12,531. Only if Nifty is able to sustain above 11,625. So what Nifty was making? Every month new high. Again, we should expect that this high making habit would be continued only if Nifty sustain above 11,625, right? So single most important level for July, jolly July, will be 11,625. Should note it in our diary. All right. Now, let us see what happened actually in jolly July. Right, where was Nifty? It was at 11,789 on 1st of the July, 31st of June. Where did nearly July came on 31st July? 11,118. So we have seen a huge fall, right? So Nifty behaved something like this in the month of July, a big red candle. See what happened actually. As discussed last month, Nifty fell below 11,625, right? So first what happened? Nifty fell below 11,625. And hence, we saw the fall further toward the expected target of 11,097, right? This was our target. So Nifty fell from 11,575 to 361 to 11,097, right? See, till well Nifty actual fell? Till 10,999. So Nifty actually fall till 11,000 and it closed at 11,118, correct? So last month was the first month with lower low, lower high and lower close after 7 months of higher high. See, as you can see, after 7 months of higher high, higher low, last month, that is the month of July, was the first month where we have seen that Nifty break its previous month low. It made lower low, lower high, and lower close. Right? See, these all three lines were our target. Let us see how it behaved. This was hard day. As you can see, Nifty fell exactly till first target. Then some 4-5 days we saw a small upward movement. Again, Nifty fell till second target, 2 days is still there, and then we have seen a huge fall till third target. So see, all the levels have some little bit of importance, correct? But we should see major trend. See what was major trend? Nifty fell for 2 days, it took 8 days to rally, but still it was not able to cover even a single day of fall. So who were carrying this ride? Bears were carrying this ride. Again, it fell, right? See, till the time we do not see this type of rally. See here what we can see? Just in 1, 2, 3 days, whole 4 of this 10 days was covered. So who was carrying ride here? This ride was carried by bulls, right? So we should see what major activity is going down. Here we have seen that fall were crucial, rallies were smaller, right? Now, Nifty was in downward correction since last 18 months. Let me again convert to monthly. Yeah, it is month. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Nifty was in downward correction since last 18 months, right? We have seen this correction since 18 months. It was not rally. See, rally was this one. Rally was this one, right? Where we were continue seeing higher high. This is not rally time. This is a correction time. So during this 18 month of correction, we have seen Nifty twice fell with lower high, lower low, and lower close. How many times we have seen Nifty fall with lower high, lower low? See, this was first time, this was second time, and this is the third time we are seeing the fall. And both the time fall was with the damage of 11,065 point and 1755 point. See, first time it has fallen 2 month and 1155 point. Then we have seen the fall again with 2 month and 1755 point, right? So we should understand that Nifty is having habit of falling for 2 months. And damage we are seeing was around 1200 to 1800 point, right? So Nifty has a habit of damaging 1200 to 1800 point in just 2 months. Last month was the first month again. That is again third time with lower low, lower high, and lower close, right? So last month was first month of fall. Again with this same pattern, lower high, lower low, lower close. And during this month, we have already seen the damage of 1104 point. See, we have already fallen 1104 point in a single month of fall. So be prepared for the correction further, but should also plan for recovery. Why? See, why we have to be prepared for further correction? Because Nifty have habit to fall for 2 months. So we need to be prepared for another month of fall, but we should be prepared for recovery plan also. Why recovery plan? Because what comes after every 2 month fall? Recovery. Here also recovery, right? Between all of this fall, we have seen the recovery of around 5 month and 8 month time wise. See, here we have recovered after 2 month fall, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 month. Here after 2 month fall, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 month recovery. So Nifty has habit of falling 2 months. And at the same time, Nifty have a habit of recovering for 5 to 8 months. We should not forget this thing. It has the habit of recovering around 1800 point and 2098 point, as this was recovery during last two fall. So buying should be done during this deep fall. Every time during the fall, we need to buy so that we can reap these rallying benefits, right? To reap the benefits of recovery to be seen around 5 to 8 months, right? So again, what we should expect after this 2 month fall? Again, 5 to 8 month recovery. If we want to take benefit of this recovery, we should accumulate during this type of fall, right? So now it's the main point of what to expecting amazing August, right? Nifty is right now 11,118. So in the month of August, considering first month with lower low, lower high, lower close. This was first month of lower low, lower high, lower close. August should be followed with a lower low. Now see, a new low this month is a normal thing. Why it's a normal thing? Because Nifty falls for 2 months anytime, right? So the negative trend could continue further to a 10,750 initially. Right, 10,750 a fall till this 10,750 should be a normal fall. Now let me delete this all levels and let me draw some new level, which 11,750 one should come here. 10,383. So the another one which should come here. Yeah. And third, 9,767. Right? This is your third and major target. Yeah, it's approximately 9,767. So see, as you can see, 9,767 would be around 50-month exponential moving average. So that was a very good point to buy, right? So these are your target, and we need to think about this target. That is 9,767 is your major target. This is the point from where we are going to see huge bounce. It could be even seen in a single month, right? Why in a single month? This is fall A. See, this was fall A, it was recovery B, this was fall C. A and C are in same time frame. This was X, right? And what comes after X? It could be again a new rally, but now as we are not in a rally, we have again started a correction mode. So what will be seen here? A, that is we are in A, which could be till 9,767. After A, what we are going to see? 8 month recovery. Now we can't say 8 month recovery. It could be 5 to 8 month recovery, right? So after A, we would be seeing 5 to 8 month recovery again towards this lifetime high. Huge good buying again should be seen only at 9,767. This buying should be limited for 5 to 8 months. Now see, after this A fall, that is 9,767, we are going to see a 5 to 8 month recovery, but that would also be for a limited period of 5 to 8 months, right? Which could be 2200 point. We might come again to lifetime high level. This would be recovery B, right? So after this A, we could enter B with 5 to 8 month recovery phase. But only those people who would accumulate during current fall would be benefit in coming recovery of 2200. Should remember, this recovery of 2200 point should be followed by fall C. As we have seen A, B, C. Again, what we can see? A, B recovery, and again C fall of 2 month with same length, correct? So fall C again with around 1200 to 800 points. And this will be final fall C, A, B, C. Let me do it here. A, B recovery, and C should be final fall. So should be prepared for this 1 month remaining falling trend, 5 to 8 month recovery trend, 1 month falling trend, 5 to 8 month recovery trend, and 2 month trend. So compounding these all and 2 month fall. Compounding these all should expect 1 month left fall, 5 to 8 month recovery. That is just count it 6 months, 6 plus 1, 7, and 2 month of fall. That is 9 month of this correction period. Still we can see, right? So we can see till here. Correction mode could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? So overall, this correction was supposed for 27 months. Compounding all these, we could say current correction has completed 18 months and left 9 months. That is 27 months. And after this 27 month, a huge rally could be seen toward 18,500. Right, so when this whole correction period will be completed, which have eaten 18 month, 9 month left, so over 27 month correction mode, after this correction, we are going to see huge rally toward 18,500 till here. All right. Till here. Who will benefit this rally? Only those people who are going to accumulate during this correction mode. Who have benefit during this rally? Those people who have accumulated during this fall. who have benefited from this rally we have accumulated during this fall, right? So plan the game and play as per plan. Be active during this whole 27 month correction and inactive during the rally of 9700 to 18000. We should be active during this whole correction mode, right? And when we are going to see the rally in only 3 years, we will see rally from 9700 to 18000, right? So during that rally, you can stay inactive. You can do same SIP in-depth fund. Right now, your SIP should be in equity because you are having equity at a very good price. So positive trend on immediate. Now see, this is your plan A, where you are expecting 9767. Now positive trend on immediate basis before going 9767 could be seen only if Nifty is able to close above 11,000. Right, only if Nifty close about this previous month low, that is 11,000, then only we are going to say that okay, Nifty can directly rally from here. So your plan B will activate. See, if rally will be coming sooner, then you are going to you will not be able to accumulate more stock. The more this correction measure stays, you are earning every month, the more better and quality stock you are going to accumulate. So pray God that this correction mode should stay longer. Yeah, it is negative right now, but this negative is actually positive for you right now. You can accumulate more, right? So this was something. See, you should see one more level. See, here there was yearly Nifty during January 2018. In the month of January, see what we have discussed during the starting of the year. These were your target. From 11,989 was your overall target, but see, 9952 was your real buying level, right? So it will be good if Nifty approach toward this level during this 2020. But remember, 10,858 is yearly pivot, and right now Nifty has already fallen till 10,850, right? Because today is 5th August. So 10,850 is a point where we should be active. We may see some consolidation phase at 10,850 and some bounce also, right? So be alert during all this level. What smart people can do, just accumulate during this whole recovery phase so that you can reap benefit during coming rally, right? Now let me again come to this monthly Nifty. Some other things also we have discussed here. See, recording is today on 5th August, but see, we have seen this, we have already updated this amazing August on 1st of August itself, right? See, pharma is a good sector right now. Pharma in short term also, they are good. See, the majority of pharma companies current result were good, right? We have given all these dollars, crude, you can see this thing. Now see, here we update regularly. We have written here revenue growth is 19%, net profit growth is 18%. Now this is not correct. We need to check actually. We are not supposed to check on 1st August because majority of result were still pending. Now I have, right, till now I have updated too many results, right? Only two, one or two companies results are pending. So let me write down now here actual revenue growth and profit growth. See, this is Nifty. These are top 21 companies. Now why 21? Because there are 50 companies in Nifty, but this 21 companies weightage, if you will count, it is around 80%. Sorry, here it is. Yeah, okay, this 21 company, if you combine their weightage, it comes to 80%. So see, 80% of the weightage comes from only 42% companies. remaining 48% companies, that is how many remaining 29 companies is responsible for only 20% weightage. So majority of weightage is from this 21 companies. So if you are able to see result of this 21 companies also, your 80% work is done, right? Now, which sector are responsible for this 80% weightage? See, here there are bank is responsible for majority, that is 29% weightage comes from bank, right? Now, in real GDP, this is not the same thing. In real GDP, manufacturing sector is responsible for a good chunk of GDP, but actual Nifty, it is different. So sometimes you say, think that, oh, why Nifty is rallying and GDP is not so good? Because some weightages are different here, right? See, bank is with highest weightage. Computer software companies, right? Like TCS, Infosys come second, around 13% weightage. Finance with 10% weightage. Now, if you combine bank and finance, it goes to 39%. So see, majority of Nifty is with the finance companies, right? So if only finance and IT goes good, na, your Nifty can be good, right? You will think then, why GDP is not so attractive, but Nifty is attractive, because see here, Nifty is composed by majorly of finance and IT companies, right? So this thing we need to understand. Automobile is here with just how much percentage? 29 bank, 13 computer, 10 finance, 9% refineries, right? Who comes in refinery? Reliance Industry. 5% to cigarette, that is ITC alone, 5%. 4% to engineering and just 3% to automobile. So you think that Maruti sales will go down, Mahindra and Mahindra sale will go down, then Nifty will fall? No, my dear friend, they are responsible for only 3% of Nifty. All right, diversified power, paint, telecom, here it is, just telecom with just 1%, right? So now here I have given some data of this top 21 companies. If you compound all of these 21 companies, then they give or they do turnover of around 24 lakh. Right, see, total Nifty 50 companies does turnover of around 51 lakh. These 21 companies are responsible for 24 lakh. Their profit is around 2,34,000. Nifty 50 companies is responsible for profit of around 3.8 lakh crore. Nifty 21 is responsible for around 2.4 lakh crore profit, right? So 63% of profit comes from only this 42% of the companies. That is, 21 companies give 63% profit. Remaining 29 companies give only 37% profit, right? So see, your companies are making profit. Now this profit is for all sale holder. Now if I am buying something, I need to see my EPS. If we will see Nifty's EPS, just total this top 21 companies, your EPS will come to 1199, right? So this is Nifty 50's, not Nifty 50's EPS, Nifty 21 EPS. But as you know, 80% weightage is from this 21 companies. You can understand that 80% of the EPS comes from here itself. So 1199 is EPS. But if you count with actual weightage, see, weightage of HDFC Bank is 10%. EPS of HDFC is 83 rupees. So what should you consider? For Nifty, 9 is EPS of HDFC Bank, because its weightage is 10%. Reliance EPS is 66.88. What we should take? 6. So if we calculate Nifty as per weightage, then its EPS comes to only 56. So 46 is actual earning of 80% Nifty. All right. If we will count for whole Nifty 50, then it could go around 55 to 60 only. So this is actual EPS of Nifty as per weightage. Now you will surprise by actual weight EPS of Nifty 50 is not this, it is 440. If you would have read somewhere, see, it is showing 440 because this actual Nifty 11,000 comes due to addition of even the dividend received every year, right? So what happens, the dividends which Nifty gives every year are counted in Nifty, right? See, what amount of dividend should we receive? Here it is. See, let me go to the Nifty chart. See, this is Nifty. Let us actually see technique. Here we can see actual how much dividend Nifty has already given this year. See, this is a Nifty dividend point index. Just click it. What you are able to see? See, this year already 81 rupees dividend has been given. Last year 140 rupees dividend has been already, 142 rupees dividend has been distributed. See, in 2017, what was the dividend distribution? 112 rupees. So this is Nifty 50 dividend, right? So you can see that till now we are in the month of August, April, May, June, July, August. 4 months have gone, and during these 4 months we have already received 80 rupees dividend. This year also we should expect around 150 rupees dividend, right? So remaining 70 rupees dividend we are going to receive in coming some month, right? So it's very simple way to calculate. Now let us come to topic. 46 was EPS as per weightage, right? This is current year revenue growth as per these all companies. So see, revenue growth, only one company was in degrowth. And which one was this? This is Maruti. Only Maruti's sales were 10% down. Else, if you will see this Nifty top 21, you can see 16% revenue growth we have seen in Nifty this year. Right? So you should expect 16% revenue growth this year. Right? This is current year profit growth. Right? Now see, current year profit growth, only these three companies are in negative return. M&M 24% degrowth. Now see, M&M degrowth 24% is last year's degrowth. It is not actual quarter one, because still result are pending. If I am not wrong, they are going to announce on just coming Saturday or might be on 17th August. Here you can see Bharti Airtel. Yeah, their profit has been bitten hugely because you know that trade war right now, right? By 600% they are down. Actually, profits have been gone from profit making to loss making last quarter. Maruti profits are down. See, otherwise majority of company profit are good. This HDFC Bank, wonderful profit. ICICI Bank, 50,000%. See, actually don't count 50,000%. Last quarter profit were worst. So this year they have done good. Now we can't say it is extraordinary good, but they have transformed from worst to good, right? So here you can see it's a huge jump. It doesn't mean that ICICI Bank result are better than HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank definitely is good one, but ICICI Bank has turned from bad to good. Right here you can see TCS, Kotak Bank, L&T, Axis Bank, SBI, these all profit have jumped good, right? Even IndusInd Bank. So majority of good result have been given by IT and bank, right? Even Asian Paint profit was very good. All right, so now if we will consider this revenue growth 16, if you will consider this current profit growth, now how can we calculate current profit growth? We can't do just average of this thing because weightages of different companies are different. So what we are doing here, see, this is forward EPS. How we have approached it to this forward EPS? That is HDFC Bank last year EPS was 83. We are expecting this year HDFC Bank to reach to 98.4 forward EPS, considering it 18% growth, right? So if you will do the same method in all this thing, don't do same method in all the thing like Bharti Airtel or ICICI Bank? Why we should not do same thing? Because the ICICI Bank profit has been rallied by 50,000, but you can't just multiply it with 50,000, right? If the last year EPS was 6, we are going to expect 26 EPS this year, right? So just if you will do this forward EPS, then actual growth is 8%. All right. So what is the growth of profit growth this year of Nifty 50? It could be around 8%, but this is also wrong because their weightages are different, right or wrong. So as per weightage, if I will calculate, then Nifty 50 approach toward 14% profit growth. So this is the answer for quarter one. Your revenue is growing by 16% and profit are growing by 14%. Right? See, Nifty is smart. If Nifty doesn't change their weightages, then it would be around 8%. But Nifty is smart enough. It uptick the weightage of outperformer and downtick the weightage of underperformer. Doing this adjustment, Nifty always wins, right? So 8% is wrong answer, 14% is right answer. So what profit growth we are expecting in quarter 1920, year 1920, we could expect around 14% growth this year, right? Yes, we know all over world there is huge fall in demand. So businesses are going to fall. Half year one, we are going to see challenging half year. Second half, we are expecting a good second half. Demand will again rise during H2, right? See, here it's the intrinsic, that is actual valuation since 2000, right? See, during the year 2000, EPS was 62 and Nifty was just trading in 1000 to 1800. As earning rise, last year EPS was 476. Nifty reached to 10,000 to 11,000. So who helped Nifty reach from 1000 to 11,000? Your answer should be earning. As earning has rise from 62 to 476, your Nifty has rise around 10x. Nifty is around 10,000, right? This is high low, high P and low P, right? So average P, we can see it's 19. 90 should be seen in Nifty as historical average P. Earning have grown by 12% during last 19 years, right? So price has also rallied by around 12% during last 19 years. So who helped rise price? Earning is helping price to rally, right? See, this is the net dividend which we have received. Every year we receive dividend. See, here you were receiving just 19 rupees dividend. Your investment of 1000 in Nifty was attracting 62 rupees earning. See, you were investing 1000 and your earning was 62. So what does it shows? It shows your yield. If you are buying at higher price, that is around 2000, your earning is same 62. So your yield would be 3. Same Nifty, if you buy at lower price, your yield would be 7. So see, 7 is really a fantastic yield. Why Nifty generally rise from this high attractive yield? Because 7% yield is good yield. If you are having 8 to 9% yield in fixed deposit, then 7% yield in stock market is attractive, because 8 to 9% yield in fixed deposit are going to be flat. But here in stock market, as companies earning rise over the period of time, we see that earning grows. Today, same Nifty earning is 476. Your yield becomes not 4-5. This is current yield. If you count as per 11,000, but if you have invested during this time, you would be having average 3 to 7 yield. But if you have invested during this time, your investment was that same amount, earning has increased, and your yield should be actually 26% per year. Now you are going to get 26% in FD or any fixed security? No. That is the reason. Stock market on longer time gives this type of return, right? If we invest right now, again, we are going to have only 5% yield as we were receiving same in thing during 2000. But on, over the period of time, we are going to see 552 earning this year as per 16%. Now, I should change this 16%. I should do here 14%. So you should expect 542 EPS this year. As per 542, your intrinsic value come to 10,300. So this is your good buying level for this year. All right. Your target for 2025 should be almost 18,000. Why? Because earning of Nifty would have increased to 939. You are going to receive dividend yearly at 265 rupees during 2025, which you are receiving today around 140 to 150, right? If I am investing right now, my yield is 5%, but my same investment yield is going to increase. So in 2025, it will be convert to 9% annual yield. See, right now fixed securities give just 6%. So 9% yield is really a fantastic yield. If I keep this investment till 2030, I should expect yearly 16% yield. So it's really, really attractive. What I need to do? Just I need to give some time to my investment. If I buy at lower level, then I'm going to give good returns. The people who are holding, who would be holding this till 2050, that is, who are planning for next 30 years, are going to have yield of 155% per year on their investment. So the more time you give, the higher your yield. Focus on this wealth creation. 155% means if I invest 1 lakh today, my yield would be 1,50,000 every year. This is called as wealth creation, right? So stay for a long time. You are going to see definitely Nifty 31,000 till 2030, right? So this was something which I have made for you. One exercise I would like to give you before we close this session. See, this we have seen for Nifty. Now Nifty is smart enough to increase his own weighted to performer and decrease his weighted to underperformer. Same thing we need to do. So exercise for you. This is your portfolio. Now, for example, if you are having 25 companies, just check out their weightage of your investment. Just see top 80% weightage giving companies. For example, if you are having just 10 companies with 18% weightage, just write down 10. If you are having 20 companies with 80% weightage, write down 20 companies. Write down name here. Write down your investment, that is your price, total investment. For example, if I am holding Maruti, my investment is, for example, I have invested around 30,000 here. Now, what is EPS of Maruti? See, EPS of Maruti is, where it's gone, 253.26, right? So I will write down 253.26 here. But see, I am holding not a one Maruti, I am holding might be five Maruti. So I will write down 253.26 multiplied by 5. So on investment of 30,000, my yield is 1,266. Clear? Current year revenue growth and profit growth. See, these both things are important. I should know actually Maruti is increasing this year or not. Let me write down here. right? So Maruti's result I have written here. Where is Maruti? Yes. It is degrowing by 10% and profit is degrowing by 32%. I will write down same here. Right? So 10% and 32%. So what should be my forward EPS? Right? Forward EPS will be is equal to 1266 multiply by this 32%. What will be your answer? Should be divide from actual yield. Oh, it becomes opposite, right? I should do this way. G8 minus yield. Forward EPS 167 is wrong answer. Just let me see what is actual my estimate of Maruti, where it's gone. Yeah, it's here. Yes, 253. Okay. Forward EPS is 173. Right? Why 173? 32% degrowth I have to count. Right? So 173. Multiply by 5, it's 865 right now. So it's last year EPS were 1266. Right now, I will expect my this year EPS at 865. So what is my yield? Let me write down here. I'll write down actual multiply by 5 price. Right? What is the price of Maruti? It's 5670. So 5670 multiplied by 5. My investment is 28,000. So count down what is the actual yield? 100 multiplied by yield divided by investment. So 3% is my yield. Right? Write down all your companies where your 80% investment is there. You will know what is your total investment. On this investment, what is your actual yield of last year? If your companies are grown or degrown by this way, what yield, what earning should you expect this year? You will be able to know actual yield. If your yield is below 2.5, then it is not actually good. Because we are having 6% yield in fixed securities. 2.5%, even if it grows by 20%, it is not going to reach easily 6%, right? So below 2.5 is not good. It should be above 3%. The more the yield, the better your portfolio, and it is less likely to fall during current fall, right? So just do this exercise and tell me, what is your current yield? Calculate and tell me your current average yield, right? So this is exercise for all of you. Kindly do this. It will help you on this buying action, right? Now see, yield is lesser. So what I will plan? Let Maruti fall even lesser. If Maruti right now it is at 56,770, for example, if I would be able to buy near 4,000, then my yield will be increased. So what I will say? I will buy Maruti around 4,000, right? My yield will increase. All right. So this is a simple way. Exercise I have given. Do this homework and update it. Okay. So thank you very much, my dear friends. And before I close, let me see if I am missing something important. Yeah, I have already updated these all things. Major buying, selling, as you have seen, majority of FIN mutual fund have actually bought too many better stocks. Yeah, see, these are some event, upcoming event. Visakhapatnam, we are going to meet on 1st September. This is the first time we would be traveling to Visakhapatnam because too many people have requested in Visakhapatnam. So yes, we are coming to your town and we are going to talk on this current result trend. Delhi, this is the third meeting for Delhi in 8th September. So please remember, this will be not same meeting which we have discussed last year. Now I will expect that many of you would have upgrade. So this time we are going to discuss current trend of sector and stock. We will be taking lesser time on basic and more time will be done on productive thing like sectors, right? Jaipur, again, it's first time. All right. So these are some event and yeah, we are going to meet on Bombay. In Bombay, I think workshop is on this coming, in the month of August, Saturday, Sunday and Monday, 10, 11, 12. We are going to do a practical 3-day program in Mumbai. So thank you very much. See you in all of these cities. Thanks and best of luck to everybody.